Hey everyone, this is Keto Tank Jim. I want to kind of stop and make a real quick video for you guys. Essentially, I want to just go over really with something I mentioned in the last video I did. I'm going to name this video something I kind of alluded to, and it's what I'm going to dive into a little bit more. Cookies and soda for breakfast. Essentially, what that is, I was in a situation when I was younger working. We'd be working out into the country, you know, not really many places to go use the restroom. That essentially was the main excuse for going into gas stations. We'd go into the gas stations in the morning and then get some breakfast. That would be pretty much where we would be getting it. We'd be up at about 5-6 o'clock in the morning every morning. So there really wasn't any time to cook breakfast at home, so we'd get it on the go. That would include some sort of McDonald's or something in the realm of whatever you can get at the gas station. So for me, as a child doing this, we'd always would get chocolate milk or some sort of soda. And that was perfectly fine for a while, but essentially, I got into the habit of doing it and not really the actual necessary need of having that type of substance in the morning. So anyways, that would be the morning routine. We would get some sort of, sugary drinks and some sort of essentially sugary breakfast. But then because we're out in the country, we have to go use the restroom. And where do we go? We can't go into the people's houses. So we would just make up reasons to go to the gas station down the road usually. So that means we're into the gas station 4 to 5 times a day. And every single time we would go into the gas station, because you're out into the country, there may or may not be a time that you're going to be going back to that place. You may go a 6 or 7 hour stretch without being able to go there. So you would always stock up on refreshments, essentially. As a young child, my father was not a very good influence in this manner, and we would always get some sort of sugary drinks. And if it was around noon, we would always get whatever gas station reheated pizza or hot dogs or cheeseburgers, whatever the gas station really, you know, made. So we would have to go there about 4 or 5 times a day. And eventually, at around 14, 15 years old, once I more or less started to go with my dad working a little bit more steadily, and then it eventually got into, after I finished school, doing it full time. But right around when I was 14 or 15 years old, I would start to get these stomach cramps towards the end of the day. And it was because I was ingesting so much sugar, and all that sugar I wasn't counting in the in like my calories or counting any type of carbohydrates, because it was just, you know, I'm just burning it off. That's what I assumed. I would be, you know, sluggish all day, but it was more or less just thinking that, you know, I always considered myself more of a train than a race car. So I was more steadily and just kind of plodding through, and we would be able to go for hours upon hours, but you know, it wasn't really efficient. Eventually, over the years, I gained about 70 pounds. And over that 70 pounds, most of it probably contributed through sugary drinks and just overall not healthy foods. And that is the reason why I really concentrate on trying to eliminate as many of those really cheap and really chemically drinks and cookies and cakes. I try my best. If I'm going to be doing any type of baking or anything like that, I'm not mimicking Reese's cups. I'm not mimicking cupcakes. If they're gonna be cupcakes or muffins, they're gonna be the consistency of proper cake. It's not going to be something that's gonna be prepackaged tasting. I don't want to have a lot of you know, diet Dr. Pepper or Diet Coke, unless I am focusing very well on most of my day being good, healthy, whole foods. I do not like a lot of artificial sweeteners or anything of that sort. I try to have as much whole foods as possible because it was such a hard addiction to break. It was something that I was in a lot of pain, and the depression that I had really embraced the addiction that I had with the sugars and the gas station foods. And as I got older and I got heavier, I would be subconsciously getting more and more of the food, and it exacerbated the problems. And like I said, I gained 70 pounds, and it was probably the hardest possible thing for me to actually break was the habit of going into the gas station to pay for fuel and making up reasons to go inside this convenience store that I didn't really have to anymore. And the main things that I did to overcome the compulsive feelings of, you know, putting fuel in, going to the gas station, getting a drink, then going to the register, and then, you know, those type of that routine and that painful break, because it is an addiction. It's a very hard habit to break, and it took me about 2 to 3 months to not immediately get out and go to prepay for fuel, because I switched over to using my debit card only. That way I didn't have to go into the gas stations. And then what I did was, if I needed to get a drink, then I would make sure I bought 3 or 4 bottles of sparkling water. That's my favorite thing to drink now. And I would get 3 or 4 bottles, and that way I would have them in the car at all times, in the pickup at all times, because that way you have it, and so you can't say that you don't have anything to drink. You always have something to drink. You always have a reason to not go in. You use your debit card at the pump. You have, you know, if you need to, you have a cooler with some drinks in it. You do not go inside. That was my thing. My problem was that whole go inside, go here, go here, go here, then go pay for everything, and then, you know, pay for everything in cash. And that was a way to, you know, not have it in your head, to disappear the calories and the sugar and the receipt, essentially, of all of the things you drank or ate. So it's not a fun experience, but I got through it. And that's what I really try to work with my clients, to shift their mindset and to focus on the things that are really, really necessary in their life and in their nourishment and in the fuel that they use for their body. I don't want to show people how to hack things, how they can have their sweet tooth and, you know, carry on with losing weight. I want to show them how a lot of the things that you have is actually an addiction, and it's hurting you. And I want to help guide you through those problems. And I know it's a really tough thing, and I'm still working on it myself, but I know all the pitfalls of that first couple months, and that's the really, really tough part. I just want to say, if you're having the same issues, if you realize that you have the same issues, if you are realizing that you kind of gotten into a bit of a rut, a bit of a habit that you kind of know that you're drinking some things that you really shouldn't be, just because they're hiding a lot of chemicals and a lot of sugar that you know you don't need to have, I definitely can help you through. I mean, that's one of the major things that I know a lot about, and I know how to kind of work your way through a lot of different type of drinks that taste a lot alike, and they taste actually better once you start to drink them. Hey, this is Jim. I just wanted to make a real quick ending for this video. if you know you kind of have the same addiction that I did, a lot of people do, but they just don't really, you know it or want to admit it. But it's overly accessible sugars. That's the main problem. So many things you have that are prepackaged and just, you know, set up when you're paying for things, you can easily grab them and go. It's just too much, and it's hard to get over that habit. And I wanna help you if you know you have those issues too. Get in touch with me, ketogenicgym@gmail.com, or just look at any of my any of my social media. They're all the same, Ketogenic Gym. Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. Get in touch with me any way you want, and I definitely can help you out. I really appreciate it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and you guys have a great day.